Thank you. Thank you for the introduction. Good afternoon. My talk is about a program hash function from Lattice and its application to short signatures and IB with small key size. This is a joint work with Jiang Zhang from State Key Laboratory of Cryptology and Yichen from State Key Laboratory of Information Security. This outline of my talk, first I will give an introduction to a program of hash function, and then we'll define how to define PHF from Lattice, and third part give an application to signatures and IBE. Program hash functions is a key to group hash function, which map a group, a set X to a group G. This hash function has two modes. The normal mode will first, there is a HG algorithm which generates a key K. And then with this key, there is a H value algorithm which maps an element from this set to an element from this group. This is a normal mode. There is a trip down mode. Which is there is an algorithm, H trip G algorithm, takes as input G and H, which are generators of this group G, and output a key prime and together with the trap dot TD. And then the H trap evaluate algorithm takes input this trap dot TD and maps this X to a pair of AX and BX. Such that the H value with the key prime on this X equals to G to AX times H to BX. Of course, it is required that the two mode, the key generated should be statically closed. And we see a PHF is a UV PHF if for any X1 to XU, Y1 to YV. Satisfying XI is different from YJ, and the probability of AXI is zero, while AYJ is not zero, is bigger than 1 over poly for some polynomial. A PHF is useful when the discrete logarithm is hard over the group G. For example, we assume that the discrete of log HG, X is unknown. Then the problem we considered is the compute FX such that the H value Z equals to H to the power of FX. This problem is computationally infeasible in the normal mode, since it's actually computed as a DR, discrete logarithm. But in the trip down mode, we have Z equals to this value for some known AX and BX. So if AX is zero, then the problem is easy, since FX is just BX. If AX is not zero, the problem is hard, since FX equals to AX times X plus BX with unknown X. So the magic power for secure proof of PHF is that both the probability of AX equals to zero and AX not zero are noticeable. So in this case, it's useful for simulated security game. And the second case is useful for embedding hard problems. Now let me give a brief state of the art. The PHF was first introduced by Hopkins and Kills in crypto 2008. They also construct a 2-1 PHF and left an open problem to find this find PHF in the lattice-based counterpart. And in Hopkins and Jack and Kills, then in 2011, use cover free set to construct a U1 PHF. And in CTRC, Yamada, Hanaka, and Kahania combine two-dimensional cover-free sets with bilinear groups to reduce the group elements. And in crypto 2012, Hanaka showed that it is impossible to construct algebraic U1 PHF of a prime order groups in a black box way, such that its key has less than U group elements. And in crypto 2013, Freire construct a poly 1 PHF from multilinear groups. And crypto last year, Catalana introduced a symmetric PHF over bilinear groups. In summary, existing PHF constructions seem specific to DL groups, and it was still unclear how to essentiate PHF from lattice, for example, with which groups and with works with which hard problems. So this work, we give a formalization of lattice-based PHF by considering the algebraic properties of lattice and aimed at capturing the partition proof technique of PHF. We also give two concrete constructions of lattice-based PHF. One is actually an abstraction from existing constructions, and the other is a novel combination of lattice and cover free sets. We also give a generic construction of signatures and IBEs, identity-based encryptions, which provide a way to unify existing schemes and also give new and efficient constructions. Now we move to the next part. As we know, for matrix A and vector U, we can define the two lattice. And there's a sixth problem called a small integer solution problem. Says that given a matrix A, find a short non-zero vector S such that S equal to zero modulo Q. And the inhomogeneous sixth problem says that given A and U, find a short S such that S equals to U modulo Q. Both problems are as hard as the SIVT problem in the worst case has been shown at high GPV, et cetera. And we see a matrix A is a trapdoor matrix. If there exists a known trapdoor that allows an efficient algorithm sample D to sample short vectors from this lattice. In the paper, we use the MP trapdoor, which for k equals to log Q, there is a public known trapdoor matrix G together with the function G inverse set to the following two conditions. Also, we use some other useful facts have been used in the literature. The first one is there is an algorithm trip G that outputs an almost uniform matrix A together with a trapdoor of A. The second fact is that for any B, if A is a trapdoor matrix, so does A can connect it with B. A and B also has also is a trapdoor matrix. The third one is if A, for any A and a small r and an invertible S, if B is a trapdoor matrix, so does this matrix. Now the definition of PHF from lattice. It is a keyed hash function which maps a set X to a ZQ to a n times M. The normal mode is euro. First, like HG now generate a key k, and then there is a h value, takes the input k and x, and my output z, which are metrics in this set. And in the trapdoor mode, we need a uniformly random matrix A and a trapdoor matrix B. The H trip G algorithm takes as input A and B and output Q prime and the trip dot TD. And then with this TD, for any X in this set, it maps to output RX and X, which are two matrix such that the output is equals to ARX plus XB. Also, we need a static closed case in the two mode, should be static closed. And we define UV PHF if for any x1 to xu, y1 to yv, satisfying xi different from yj, the probability of sxi is zero, while syj is invertible, is no less than 1 over poly k for some polynomial. This is a definition of a lattice-based PHF. Then we give two constructions of PHF from lattice. The first one, let E be a deterministic encoding from a set X to this a vector of matrix. The HG algorithm first randomly choose an L plus Y matrix and output them as the key. The H evaluate algorithm simply first maps X with the encode into a matrix C1 to CL, and then return Z equals to A0 plus the summation of Ci Ai for I from 1 to L. Actually, this function has actually been implicitly used to control both signatures and encryption. Our second construction will use a V cover free set over this domain. This domain means the set of numbers from 0 to n minus 1. Family CF, each element is a CFX, which is a subset of n, and X is taken from this set. This family is said to be V cover free if for any subset of L, and the size is no more than V. Then for all Y does not belong to S, CFY is not covered by the union of CFX. And CF is a set eta uniform if each element have size eta. For example, for n equals to 5, this CF is a 3 uniform to cover free set. And it has been shown that there is a deterministic PPT algorithm that on input integer L and V returns an eta uniform V cover free set for this N and eta. The key idea of the type 2 construction notice that a V cover free set give a partition of L in the sense that for any S subset of LS, the size is no more than V, and Y does not belong to S, then there exists an element Z star in CFY, and Z star does not belong to the unit of CFX. Since CF is defined over this domain, if we assign a unique key material for each element in this set, it seems safe to unbind some trapdoor by getting the target element Z star. However, such a direct use will result in a key size which is proportional to n. This is even worse than the type 1 construction. Our solution is to use the binary representation of A and let mu equals to log n for every one from 0 to mu minus 1. We assign a matrix for the S position. To do so, we define a function, func kzi, which is defined by if I equals to mu minus 1, the function equals to a mu minus 1 minus b minus 1 g. And otherwise, it equals to ai minus big times g inverse func kz I plus 1 by this inversion. And then for the binary representation of z, b0 to b minus 1, we can define this function. And we get we retransact the unique matrix as func kz0. Let this star be some target element And let B0 star be mu1 minus 1 star be the bit binary representation of this star. If we set AI as this form, then we get AZ is actually ARZ plus SZG for some RZ. And SZ has this form. It's a product of 1 minus BI star minus BI times IN. So for this SZ, if Z is different from Z star, then we have there is always one term equals to 0. So the SZ is 0. If Z does not equal to Z star. And if Z equals to Z star, then we can deduce that SZ equals to minus 1 to the power of C times IN, where C is the number of ones in the binary representation of Z star. By this binary representation, we can reduce the key size to log n. And by this fact, and SZ has this form, we can keep the partition property for PHF. So okay, here is a type 2 construction of PHF from lattice. Here mu is equals to log n and k equals to log q. And the HG algorithm first randomly chose a hat and ai from the set and return the k equals to a hat ai for I from 0 to mu minus 1. And the H evaluate algorithm take an input on x and returns a hat plus sigma func kz0 for z for all z in CFX. We can prove that H is actually a one-way PHF that is for a random z star from z set. If AI is set as before, and set a hat equals to this form, then we have sx is a 0 and syj equals to this form holds with probably no less than 1 over n for any yv and x does not belong to different from yj. This is simply because the cover free set holds we have just mentioned before. Third part, let me show how to apply PHF from lattice to construct a signature and identity-based encryption schemes. A signature scheme will consider three parts. The first is the KG algorithm. This algorithm, the first runs the TrapG algorithm to output a matrix A together with a trapdoor R. Then we run the HG algorithm of the PHF and get a key k. And we also need a uniform vector u and return aku as the verification key for the signature scheme. And r is a secret key. From this construction, we see that the key size is essentially determined by the size of the PHF key. To send a message M, we first run the H value algorithm on the message M to get HKM, and then we construct AM as this form. Note that R is a trapdoor for A, so we also have a trapdoor for AM. Then we can run the sample ID algorithm on AM and U to sample a short vector E and return this vector as a signature. To verify a signature, we also run this H value algorithm and get HKM, and then we form AM. And then we check whether the norm of E satisfies this condition, and AM times E equals to U. This is a verification algorithm. We see that the signature is a single vector. And the verification key, if we apply the second type 2 PHF of a previous construction, then the verification key is actually a log n. the correctness for the fact if A is a chapter matrix, so is AM is also a chapter matrix. And for the security proof, we remember that for our construct in the chapter model, we have that HKM is actually AR plus SB for some small r. And for the sending queries, we have that this S is invertible, so we can generate signatures. And for the forged message, this S is actually zero. Therefore we can solve the inhomogeneous sys problem by the chip down. Next is the application to identity-based encryption. IBE scheme consists of four algorithms. The first is setup. This algorithm also first runs the triple G to generate a matrix A together with the triple R. And then we run the HG algorithm of the PHF function to generate a key. And we also generate a matrix U from this set and return the MPK, AKU as a master public key, and R is a master secret key. Also, the master public key size is determined by the size of kernel. To extract a secret key for an entity with ID, we first run the H eval algorithm to generate HK ID, and then we form AID as before as a signature scheme, and we can sample EID from with this R and AID, and return SK ID equals to EID. And to encrypt a message M, we first run virtual S and sample X0 and X1 from these two distributions. And then use this chapter algorithm, where A is here, B is some chapter matrix, and get a key prime and a TD. And then by this chapter evaluate algorithm, on this input ID, we get RID and SID. Then the ciphertext of C0 and C1 is formed by this form, where C0 is a UTS plus X0 plus Q over 2 M. And C1 equals to AIDS plus X1 and RID X1. And return this C as a ciphertext. To decrypt a ciphertext, we simply compute C0 minus EID C1, which denotes a B. For this vector, and each exponent, we compare the BI with Q over 2. And then we can get to determine M is 0 or M is 1. The correctness is the same as before, but the security need a high mini entropy properties. We require that the key and the key prime is closed even conditioned on this knowledge. And we also require that RxV is closed to uniform if V is selected uniformly. This guarantees the programmability property still holds even if this term might leak some information of the TD. Okay. Conclusion, we present the formalization of lattice-based PHF and give a generic construction of a signature and IBE from lattice-based PHF. And we also present a new signature and a fully secure IBE with small key size using our Type 2 PHF. This paper also give an improved signature scheme by combining different PHFs. Okay, that's all. Thank you for your attention.